Okay, Houma, Louisiana, at this time, I would like to introduce, bring to the ring, your Pro Wrestling 225 Tag Team Champions, the Dogs of War.
Oh boy. Landon, it was right here in Houma, Louisiana, where we saw the formation of the team of the Mad Dog, Gil Gracie, and Lucha Lacura, the 225 Tag Team Champions, the Dogs of War.
Listen, there are men who have ambitions, who have goals, who work as hard as they possibly can to gain the admiration of the fans and strive to one day make it to the top of the mountain. These are not men. These are the Dogs of War. 126 days ago, as you said, inside this very building, Gil Gracie and Lucha Lacura shocked the world by aligning their vision together with Big Ramp Enterprises and honing their sights on the Pro Wrestling 225 Tag Team Championship. And in their very first match as a team, they claimed the richest prize in this incredibly talented tag team division in PW225. Who is going to stop the Dogs of War?
Okay.
Can I hear more from Big Ramp?
We heard that all got some tag teams that came on down since they've been all over the world and everywhere saying they want some of the dogs. Y'all don't think somebody wants some of the dogs? Come on, Charlie. This is the real in the matter. Man, don't get aggressive. Lucha Lacura, Dogs of War. If you want some, come get some. Because if you mess with the dogs, you gon' get bit. So bring it all out here if you feel like that. I have to feel, because we is ready. And if you're not down with that, I got three words for you. Shut your face.
Is that an open challenge from the Dogs of War?
Well, we know who's here. One of the hottest tag teams in the Gulf South. And they'll come out when they're damn good and ready.
And look at that, though. Gil Gracie with a mask on, maybe matching Lucha Lacura. Thus, the idea of them being more cohesive as a team is terrifying.
I mean, you have to imagine. They've spent this time now as champions getting inside of each other's head. And let me tell you, inside of Lucha Lacura's head is the last place I want to be. Here they are. And if you ask me, it was only a matter of time until we saw these guys in Pro Wrestling 225. RDS. That's right, it's superstar Jay Lucas and the real deal Teriyaki. Trained under the legendary Nightmare Factory, these guys are the real deal. And they're an incredibly hungry team here stepping in to the, red-hot tag team division here in Pro Wrestling 225. They're ready to take on every challenge that stands in their path. But let me tell you something. Tonight, it's going to be a doozy.
These guys are young and ready to climb to the top of the ranks. They were just recently on AEW Dark, so they have been making their climb across the country here in the tag team division, and these guys have it all. RDS, Jay Lucas, and Teriyaki. This is going to be one hell of a matchup at Danger Zone.
Do not blink. And man, the first defense of the Pro Wrestling 225 Tag Team Championship. Or actually a non-title match, I've been told. which actually,
what does that say?
Well, you know, it doesn't surprise me. It's big, you know, Big Ramp comes out here with all these promises, waving around the titles. I'm assuming it's a title match, but no, of course not.
Here we go. And listen, what's so cool about this team, RDS, is that superstar Jay Lucas is from New Orleans, Louisiana, and this is his home state debut.
Man,
what a way to make a debut against the Dogs.
The real deal, standing across the ring for Lucha Lacora. Lucha Lacora, wait a minute, looks like he's grabbing that arm, trapping Teriyaki right here in the beginning. God, these two are absolute elite tag teams. And I mean, what a treat we're getting here in Danger Zone.
And you can just watch. We know from seeing Lucha Lacora here at Pro Wrestling 225, he almost has eyes in the back of his head as they're trying to jockey for position here. It's almost like he's still got his eyes on Jay Lucas at the same time as Teriyaki,
looking for how to turn it around, and he does. Now going to that side headlock on Teriyaki. But Teriyaki's so quick on his feet. But wait a minute. And another reversal. Who's going to get the upper hand here? Oh, man, what is this? Absolutely incredible. Innovative, high-flying offense from Teriyaki.
Well, he is the innovator, right? And you don't see a lot of headlock takedowns like that with him.
I've never seen that before in my life. And look at this. He's got that hard hold. Wait, shoulders down. And Lucha Lacora finds the escape with that head scissors. Teriyaki able to escape that. Back and forth we go, back down with that side headlock.
A more textbook version, I think I would say, of the headlock takedown there, this time from Lucha Lacora.
Wait a minute, Teriyaki turning it over.
Look, that was smart. He used the neck to bridge out, and now it's the head scissors that he's got, this time on Lucha. As Lucha, look at this.
Oh, man.
Look at this.
These are elite competitors like you'll only see in Pro Wrestling 225. Up and over, Teriyaki slides across the ring, and what a monkey flip. No, Lucha lands on his feet.
Oh, my God. Looked right back at Teriyaki.
That was terrifying. Wait a minute. Oh, man.
Look at that drop kick.
Red hot offense here to kick things off. What a match this is already.
Do you think the Dogs of War are regretting their open challenge just a little bit here?
Wait a minute. Oh. Sweeps the legs and, oh, man, flips over. Have you ever seen someone get in the ring that way?
It's an innovative offense. Teriyaki is full of innovative offense. Only 20 years old.
Wait a minute. Here comes the superstar.
See how they work together as a team. Up and over. And stereo drop kicks to Lucha Lacora.
RDS showing what it means to be one of the best tag teams in the Gulf South. And look at this, we get some more. Up and over for the flip senton. Wait a minute, here's the cover. Gil Gracie not gonna let the match end just like that. But
could
man,
you imagine coming in to Pro Wrestling 225 is your first night in Pro Wrestling 225 and you get a pinfall victory over the Dogs of War?
Absolutely not how I saw this match starting. And wait a minute. Changing direction is Lucas. Oh, man, gets the leg up. Lucha Lacora seems to be trying to catch his breath. Maybe RDS a little more quick on their feet than the Dogs of War were anticipating. But, I mean, they didn't have any time to prepare this open challenge.
Right.
I think you're right. Maybe they were a little too overconfident here.
Elevation there from Jay Lucas, and now going to the top.
Speaking of elevation, Jay Lucas gonna fly, and what a drop kick!
That might do it right there.
And the Mad Dog in again to break things up.
Lucha Lacora does need a tag. I am surprised. Not that because I didn't believe in RDS. I'm just surprised at this open challenge and how poorly it's gone so far for the Dogs of War.
And man, it looks like RDS has absolutely found their rhythm here, focusing in, keeping Lucha Lacora isolated. But wait a minute, Lacora turning things around. Now Teriyaki looks like he hit real hard. Oh, No wonder he hits so hard. Do you see that? The middle turnbuckle, I'm not sure if you can see, the middle turnbuckle pad is off. Teriyaki's back just, Teriyaki's back just hit that exposed turnbuckle, and Lucha Licora just like that, taking full advantage.
Well, and I think he noticed, because he just caught Teriyaki there and landed him into a backbreaker right after he hit that exposed turnbuckle. And now, like a mad dog, in comes Gil Gracie.
Smelling blood in the water, focusing in on that back. And wait a minute, Jay Lucas tried to get the tag and did it in a big back body drop, doing a little bit more damage. Oh, man. Elevation on the forearm. Only a two count. I tell you what, Gil Gracie, one of the most decorated athletes in the Gulf South. A dangerous competitor. Look at this gorilla press slam.
A gorilla press slam from someone whose arm was in a cast no more than a few weeks ago.
Unbelievable. And again, you have got to be kidding me.
I didn't think it was possible for the Mad Dog to look scarier. But look at him in his mask and showing that strength.
Absolutely intimidating. And now he's just raining down shots on Teriyaki. Man, this match has done a 180 quick. In comes Lucha. Again, look at this. Now keeping Teriyaki isolated.
That is not the corner you want to be in if you're RDS. Teriyaki needs to find a way out and needs to find a way to Jay Lucas. But these quick tags from the Dogs of War just stomping away. That's a real deal.
Man, there is nothing like live Pro Wrestling 225 action. We are here in the East Park Rec Center in Houma, Louisiana. If you are not here, you need to make sure you make it to the next Pro Wrestling 225 event. It is going to be a clash.
That's right, Clash 2 from the Columbia Expo Center in Columbia, Mississippi. Just 3 weeks away, September 17th. It's going to be a great, great show in Columbia. For more information, make sure you're keeping up with Pro Wrestling 225 on all social media. That's Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and even TikTok, Landon. As the Mad Dog.
I'm on TikTok.
You're on TikTok. You do a lot of dances?
I think I've got the chicken dance down.
No. A TikTok wasn't a 90s thing.
What?
Yeah.
You think the chicken dance was a 90s thing?
It sure isn't a 2022 thing.
And look, Gil Gracie going back to work. Wait a minute, cover here. George Strong says two.
Big Ramp making his presence felt, this time with the air horn on the outside.
That doesn't surprise me.
Full of air is Big Ramp.
Hot air, you might say.
Right.
And a couple other things. And Lucha Licora, oh, man. Open palm strikes here in the corner.
And now basically taunting Jay Lucas, but
wait a minute.
Out goes Licora. This is Teriyaki's moment to make it to the corner to tag.
He could do it, Jay Lucas, right here. Just an inch away, and oh, man, right at the last second, Lucha Licora pulls the superstar away from the corner. And going back in, Teriyaki is in trouble.
Drags him all the way back to the Mad Dog. In comes Gil Gracie without the mask, which means he must mean business.
Well, the mask, you know, had to have been restricting a little bit of oxygen, doing a little strength training.
The question is, was it Gil Gracie the whole time?
Who else would have been under that mask? I mean, it could have been Michael White.
Could have been.
Wait a minute. Is Gil Gracie Mater?
Gil
different
Grace,
mask. Different mask.
Gil Gracie.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Big Ramp has dropped the air horn just so he could choke out the life of Teriyaki on that bottom rope while Gil Gracie had our official George Strong distract.
Now the air taken out of the real deal. And Gil Gracie.
And out of this crowd here in Houma, Louisiana.
Wait a minute. Look at still signs of life. What heart from Teriyaki. But, I mean, these dogs of war are hungry. Like Big Ram said, when they take a bite into you, they don't let go.
But, and as evident, Enziguri there.
But as evident, did you see that? Lucha Licora did drop, but as soon as he did, he grabbed that ankle of Teriyaki, making it impossible for him to make it over to Jay Lucas. And just tag team work at its best. In comes Gil Gracie again.
Are you surprised at how cohesive the Dogs of War look, being this just their second match together as a team?
I can't be surprised. These two just have too much experience. And yes, they've only been together for a few months, but I mean, that's just how good these two are. Talk about one of the most prolific pro wrestling 225 heavyweight champions of all time in the Mad Dog Gil Gracie. And Lucha Licora, we have seen have match of the year candidate after match of the year candidate. We're talking with guys like Christian Blake, like Corey Constantine, and now aligning himself with Big Ramp Enterprises and Gil Gracie. I mean, this team is just unstoppable. Wait a minute. No. Separation. And here it is. Tornado DDT. Teriyaki, exactly what he needed to get back in this thing.
He has to get to the corner and tag in superstar Jay Lucas. And Lucas wants that tag so badly here.
Chomping
in his home state.
At the bit.
The Pro Wrestling 225 family wants the tag as well. Can he get there?
Oh, man, you could cut the tension with a knife.
In
He's
comes
so
Gracie.
Close.
And in comes Lucas.
Here we go. Lucas, hard forearm, brings down Gracie. Elbow. Ducks under. Look at this. Oh, man, what a clothesline. Jay Lucas, the superstar, on fire right now. Kick to the midsection and to the face. Mad Dog's in trouble. Wait a minute. And
oh!
That German suplex, and he hangs on. Bridges up, shoulders are down.
I can't tell you the last time I saw Gil Gracie on the receiving end of a German suplex.
What a match this is. Oh, George Strong narrowly avoids getting hit there. Lucha Licora, wait, Lucha Licora gets sent to the outside. Here we go. The real deal sends a knee right there in the corner into Mad Dog Gil Gracie.
It's RDS's turn to get some tandem offense in, and there it is, forearm back to the superstar.
Wait a minute.
Oh!
And this is the star maker. Oh, man.
That might do it there, the cover.
Wait a minute. Lucha in to break it up right when Gil needed him most. Oh, man, a meeting of the minds here. And wait a minute, Teriyaki, good God, the athleticism. Back and forth we go, and oh, no, we've seen this before.
The Lucha driver.
The Lucha driver taking Teriyaki out. I mean, he's seeing stars right now.
And now we are in a very dangerous situation. Jay Lucas alone in the ring with the Dogs of War. Oh, we've seen this too.
Up and over, and look at the, oh man. This tandem offense from the Dogs of War, this pack mentality, and oh, wait a minute.
Wait.
It's broken up, that was only a two. Only a two count, says referee George Strong. This thing is going to continue.
Teriyaki in at the very last second, and he actually pushed Lucha Licora onto the pinfall attempt to break it up. Unbelievable moxie from such a young team.
What a match here in the historic East Park Rec Center. This is Danger Zone. This is Pro Wrestling 225.
All four men in the ring. What's going to happen?
Oh, man. And the Dogs of War getting there first, but
I think George Strong may have lost control of this just a little bit. What's going to happen here?
Oh, come on.
Something's got to give.
Let him go. What a match.
Go!
Oh, hard shot here in the corner. Looks like Dogs of War have them both set up in the corner. They're going to meet in the middle. But wait a minute, no. Do-si-do we go. And oh, the Dogs of War using it to their advantage. That's experience. And I knew that was going to be the deciding factor in this match, the experience factor over this young and hungry team.
And again, we're back into this position. Superstar Jay Lucas stuck alone in the ring.
Oh, he's in trouble.
And I don't blame George Strong. Oh, my God.
Are you kidding me?
Exactly what I was going to say. I don't blame George Strong for letting them stay in the ring because of something like that, when we know that Mad Dog is the only legal competitor.
I mean, how intimidating is it to try and referee people like Lucha Lacora and Mad Dog Gil Gracie? And now we see Big Ramp. What is this?
Oh, my God.
Big Ramp coming in with a forearm to Teriyaki. Are you kidding me? What is this? All right, that's it. George Strong calling for the bell. This one's thrown out. Are you kidding me? Why?
No witness of this match by disqualification. Let's keep on. Superstar Jay Lucas and the real deal, Teriyaki, RDS.
Well, don't look surprised, Lucha. What'd you expect?
They don't look like winners.
It's not George Strong's fault. They're looking to blame anybody. Blame Ramp. This is absolutely uncalled for. We had a classic of a tag team contest in the middle of that ring between four extremely talented athletes. And this is how it ends?
But Landon, let's not be surprised. Yes, sure, the Dogs of War laid out an open challenge. But if you think for one moment that was anything more than just a chance to beat some teams down, beat some sense into somebody who thinks they can step up to the Dogs of War, then you've got another thing coming. I'm sure that was the plan all along.
Well, guess what? This is going down in the record books as an L in the L column for the Dogs of War.
What a debut for RDS in Pro Wrestling 225. They may not look like winners right now, but they impressed the Pro Wrestling 225 family here
in Houma,
Louisiana.
Without a doubt. Are you kidding me? What a match. Man, I tell you something. Danger Zone has not disappointed. What a show we have had so far, and there is still so much yet to come.
You're absolutely right. Incredible debut from RDS there, despite Big Ramp's interference. It's been a controversial night so far, but we are about to raise the stakes, because coming up next here at Danger Zone, the Gulf State Wrestling Heavyweight Championship will be on the line as the Beast Minotaur goes one-on-one with Mustang Mike.
I absolutely cannot wait. We gotta send it up to Alexis Windsor to get this one started.